a game. It's called the ultimatum game, and you have a big-ish pot of money. But you have to split this pot with me. You need to decide how you want to split the pot. Think 80-20 or 50-50, and suggest that to me. If I agree, we both get our share. But if I reject the offer, neither of us get any money. What do you do? This game has been used a lot in tests of fairness, and things like your brain chemistry or electrical stimulation of certain brain regions affects how people decide to split the pot, and if others accept their offer. In one study, participants were given a pill of amino acids or a placebo, and then they played the ultimatum game. Those who had the amino acid pill rejected unfair offers in 80% of cases, and those who took the placebo rejected unfair offers 65% of the time. The amino acid pill didn't include tryptophan, the amino acid necessary to synthesize serotonin, a chemical that plays a role in regulating emotion during social decision making. So reduced serotonin resulted in more resentment towards the offer, making the responders less likely to accept it. Another study bent the rules of the ultimatum game. When the participants first split the pot, they offered 10 to 25% of the value to their partner. But if their partner had the power to change the way they split the pot, their initial offer jumped to 40 to 50%. Then the ultimatum game became electrifying. Some participants received electrical stimulation that increased activity in a brain area thought to control fairness. And on average, those people increased their original offer by 33%. Others received electrical stimulation that decreased activity in the same area, and they decreased their original offer by 22%. And a recent study found that participants offered their partner more money from the pot when they were given tolcapone, a drug that prolongs the effects of dopamine, compared to a placebo. It's kind of mind-blowing that our sense of fairness and inequality can be manipulated by drugs and electrical stimulation. But can you really win the ultimatum game? Have you won if you get 20 or 40% of the pot because it's more money than you had before? Or do you have to get more money than the other person to really win? Based on rational self-interest, responders should accept any offer above zero, and proposers should offer the smallest amount possible. But studies have shown almost half the players will reject offers of 30% or less, meaning you're kind of paying to stop the other player from getting more money than you. You're willing to pay for equality. So how would you split the pot of money with me? Let me know what you think and how you would split the money in the comments, and I'll let you know if I would accept your offer. And if you don't already, subscribe to BrainCraft. I have a new episode out every Thursday.